Welcome to Little Packinots Weekend Update, where we talk about what's been happening in the world of gaming. This week's episode has IKEA furniture, Cyberpunk 2077, a UFO, Twitch players flying a plane, and more. I'm your host, Little Packinot. Find me on Twitch, Discord, and of course, you're watching me on YouTube.
The show has changed names. Why, you ask? That's none of your business.
Why are you asking? This is my show! This is my show! It's not your show! Why do you even think you have the right to ask? As I was saying, the name of the show has changed since I discovered numerous imposters using the This Week in Gaming name. So this week we launched Little Packinots Weekend Update. You may have heard of the little-known Saturday Night Live's Weekend Update, but those guys can never keep a host for long, so no competition there. As we do every week, I would like to highlight a new subscriber to the channel. Welcome and thank you, LTroller333, you're an absolute legend. 2 months before Cyberpunk 2077's release, and already the first Platinum Trophy has been won for 100% completion of the game. Lucas Babiel, a developer at CD Projekt Red, shared a screenshot with the caption, "Just a normal day at work." Cyberpunk 2077 has been delayed twice from its original April release date. But with the team at CD Projekt Red putting on the finishing touches, it looks like the game is near completion and will be ready for the drop date of November 19th. Hogwarts Legacy is an open role-playing game set in the Harry Potter universe, coming soon in 2021. The story takes place years before the boy who lived attended the school. Players will play the role of a witch or wizard and experience life as a student at the Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. Throughout the adventures, new spells and combat skills can be learned, and friends can help fight deadly foes. The trailer reveals that the events of the story will take place in the late 1800s with multiple creatures. Hogwarts and the Village of Hogsmeade being shown. Expecto Patronum! If you have any money left from buying your gold PS5 last week, how about ponying up $900 to have Keanu Reeves from the John Wick, Matrix, and Speed movies on your desk? Cyberpunk 2077's Johnny Silverhand is getting his own collectible figure. The figure has a full closet of accessories you can use to customize Johnny. There will only be 2,077 units of the deluxe edition made. Damn, I need to get this channel monetized and start selling little Packinot merch. Twitch players in a chat room have managed a complete flight of a Boeing 787 Dreamliner. Taking off from Kozik, Slovakia, flying for an hour, and then landing safely back at Kozik International Airport. This all took place on Twitch Plays Flight Simulator, which is the work of a game developer, Rami Ismail, using Twitch Chat Hivemind to play Microsoft Flight Simulator. This changes the whole fly-by-wire thing. All you Kratos fans, rejoice! God of War Ragnarok is coming to PlayStation 5 in 2021. The sequel to the 2018 PlayStation 4 title will probably pick up the journey of Kratos and his son, Atreus. In the end credit teaser in the last game and the mention of Ragnarok, the two will continue to battle against the gods and heroes of the North Pantheon, including Thor. Thor has been busy lately, finishing up with the Avengers and defeating Thanos. He's moved on to the Guardians of the Galaxy, and now he'll take on Kratos. Busy guy. With many weeks still to go in Little Packinots, Fortnite Season 5 Battle Pass giveaway is still anyone's game. Probably is leading Dark Phantom with Sir Millie in a distant third. Just like the tortoise and the hare, it's not over till someone crosses the finish line. The game graveyard is now home to some really bad games. This week is no exception, with a game that was so badly received that shortly after its release, the big boss of the developer, Square Enix, issued an official apology, stating that the Final Fantasy brand had been greatly damaged. Final Fantasy XIV made its debut in 2010 and quickly was criticized for poor controls, grind-heavy gameplay, and confusing user interface. Square Enix eventually shut down the game servers in 2012. The developer felt it was necessary to rebuild the game from the ground up to regain the trust of fans.
Final Fantasy XIV-A, Realm Reborn, was the result, and since its release in 2013, it has kept the franchise alive. As for the original Final Fantasy XIV, the fantasy is dead and the game has reached its final destination.
We have the PlayStation from Sony, Xbox from Microsoft, but possibly the best name from a manufacturer for a gaming device comes from Dell. The UFO from Alienware. Little green men zipping around space coming to planet Earth soon. IKEA will be teaming up with Asus to create a line of gaming furniture. Great. A budget brand computer maker and a low-quality Swedish furniture store will make desks and chairs that won't even survive the first rage a gamer throws at it. That's if they were even able to build it in the first place. Why are there so many screws and things left over? Little Packinot's Back to School contest is underway for a legendary skin worth 2,000 V-Bucks. Once again, the rules are simple. Sign up the most new subscribers who mention your name in the comments and you win. With a little over a week to go, Extreme Plays is leading the way. Looks like he wants a legendary skin to go along with his Extreme Plays. Soon, you can get shot in the face by Vas Montenegro in Far Cry Virtual Reality Dive into Insanity. The games will be hosted at select locations of Zero Latency VR, a company specializing in on-site, expansive free-roaming virtual reality experiences. Dive into Insanity will put players directly into the action of a traditional Far Cry game, with all of the explosions and gunfire that you are used to. Playing will be a lot like laser tag. Up to 8 players strap on a backpack and headset to explore the world. That is all for this edition of Little Packinot's Weekend Update. Thanks for watching, and don't forget, if you're not getting a little salty, then you're not really playing. Now entering the semi-final battles for your best video game character ever! Representing Nintendo, Mario and Princess Peach were in a different league, easily defeating their opponents last week. In a closer battle, Sonic edged out Crash Bandicoot for the win, while Pac-Man took down Ratchet. So the matchups are the legend of gaming, Pac-Man, whose original Japanese name, Puck-Man, was changed to prevent people from changing the P to an F, taking on that cute, parasol-twirling Princess Peach. No strangers to fighting each other, Mario and Sonic go head-to-head and to decide once and for all who is worthy of competing for the title of the greatest video game character ever.